doubles. I think, this is Grand Finals. Fox goes everywhere. This side down making a bit of a triumphant return after hand problems and playing Dragon Ball Fighters for way too long. But teaming with John Money here, I think, I can't remember if this is, I think this is Winners Finals as well. So, a run back. Danny Phantom, obviously, probably the best doubles player in the state, probably the best player in the state right now, if we're being honest. Stellar results against everybody else in the state, and O'Reilly, honestly. I think he's even with O'Reilly this PR season. And I can't really tell who. Usually, usually Nico wears a tag, but I can't really tell which one he is. So we're gonna do Fox 1 and Fox 2 for now. But game 2, going to Yoshi's. Yoshi's is kind of the gamble pick, especially in a Fox Ditto doubles. It's basically like we're just gonna hope to out cheese you. And I mean, John is a Shine Edgeguard fiend, so this makes sense for him to take it. But he did just get Shine himself. I think Wadu Heck is John because he went for that. That was a super John Money Shine. But even after that Edgeguard, it's still Red Team with one stock ahead. And a lot of percent on one of those foxes. And yeah, there's the back throw. They really pretty much have to get a game. There's another back throw, and they might actually get one. Oh, random misses up, messed up the shine, though. And that up smash is going to take care of one of them. 81%, and this fox is probably just going to get juggled around for a while. And yeah, that'll be 2-0. I think the only game they've dropped this entire tournament so far is to me and Matt, which is kind of funny. Mostly because we cheesed the hell out of them on FD, as Doc does. Going back to Yoshi's again, I feel like they've probably got thoroughly outclassed on every stage in Winners Finals and Grand Finals, and they're kind of just hoping for something. I mean, it started off pretty well with an SD from probably Nico. Shout out to Nico. Let's see if they can actually do anything with this, because they're racking up a ton of percent right now. They're getting... One thing that I noticed with Blue Team is that they're just, like, getting caught in these scrambles a lot, where it looks like both of them want to do the same thing at the same time. That's an easy problem you can have when you're both playing Fox, and Fox can do literally anything at any time he wants, so you end up just crossing the paths a lot. And if you look at Red Team, Nico and Danny, they're not really doing the same thing at all. They're boxing them in, they're not crossing the streams where they try to... They try to run past each other to get the same hit, but they're just not doing that. They're comboing off of each other really well. That's one of the main things I noticed, is that their Fox combo game, team combo game, is really just really polished. Oh, as I say that, one of them gets shined, and they're actually, that's two unfortunate stocks. Let's see if either of these, okay, they got two gimps. Okay, back to even, pretty much. Two pretty easy gimps. Let's see what they can do. Blue team is just, they're getting good good openings, but they really just aren't converting off them. It very much looks like they're trying to play 2-1v1s. Ooh, he went for the crazy shine. Didn't really get punished for it. That up smash, though, that was good coverage by the second fox. He let the first fox go out there and get a back air, and he just kind of sat back with an up smash in case he went straight in. Which is kind of a read, because there's definitely a lot more angles you can go for, but it definitely worked out. And they're clawing this back. They got a few lucky SDs and Randall shenanigans, but they're clawing it back. Let's see if they can take a game. Getting a good up smash as well. They're racking out tons of percent, and that back air, that'll do it. Oh, he texts the shine as well. That shine could have actually saved the game, because the other fox is at 110. And yeah, he tried to get the gimp on that fox. That'd have been so much easier, but they do manage to take a game. Let's see what the counter pick is. Because it's a 4 Fox Ditto tournament, or match, I guess, it's definitely going to be just a style sort of thing. And they're going FD. This is really, like, even more so in doubles and singles, I think. This is just like the I'm a better player than you, I'm going to, like, chain grab you to death kind of counter pick. But it's also really kind of, it's difficult to acclimate yourself to how playing as differently as you have to do on FD. So sometimes it can take a little bit to kind of get used to it. I know when we played them, we kind of destroyed them on FD, and they took us back, and it was like a 6 stock. They just had to figure out how to play against them. And I mean, it's pretty even so far, but they are racking damage up. Ooh, back throw. Oh my god, that Fox went all the way out there. That was John. John going all the way out there for that game. And it pays dividends. That Shine. The edge guards are looking a little less crisp. John kind of overextending, though, and gets punished really hard for it. And now it's even again. This should be, yeah, that's just a back air to the death. They're grouping up a lot more, which is, it can be good and bad. Grouping up is a good strategy, kind of balling up, but you really have to make sure not to. You have to be really inside your teammates' head so you don't end up trying to do the same thing at the same time. Somebody farting back here. And, oh, John with a really high angle, but he was just a bit too far away to float back to stage. What was that? He literally just charged an F smash. Oh, good nair there to cover it, but I think, he actually edge guarded himself, his own teammate. I think if he did a better getup, that he would have been able to get back on stage just fine. Regardless, it is still even. Damage. That was a really, really high up B. I think that's a questionable decision because it's really easy to just get juggled there and then they can just take the 2v1 while you're trying to recover. Even though Fox is really fast, if you up B at weird angles like that, it's still pretty easy to just kind of juggle you. And that up smash does not get who he wanted. That one, though. Hey, Jason. What's up? We got a game 4. This actually Nico and company's counter pick. They're kind of getting washed a little bit. Like, they SD'd a lot. They're getting washed. Now they're getting washed. Yeah. See, I can read into the future. Okay, finally, Blue Team has not been showing off any combo game whatsoever. It looks like they were just playing 2 1v1s for most of the games. But they should be able to clean this up pretty easily. Or they can just, yeah. I mean, they're playing really safe, so it works. And they managed to bring it to game 5. We could see a reset here. That'll be interesting. Nico's looking sad. I can see it in his face. He's looking distressed. I can kind of like hear what he's thinking. He's like, this is bullshit. Fox is so dumb. They're going back to FD. Okay, he put on the tag. Now I know who Nico is at the very least. Alright, Danny. Getting that combo pretty good. So many up smashes, oh my god. And they got John knocked really low, but that up B saves him. I think, well, if they went for the Shine, it could have put him into a tech situation, but it would have at least been better than just letting him get back. And that Shine will catch his jump. That should be a stock for Nico. Oh, he tried to do the drill. And now they're both trying to edge guard each other. And, messed up, yeah. I was worried about Nico extending that edge guard because it looked like he might have not been able to get to Danny in time to save him. From kind of, I think he's getting reversal on a little bit, but that worked. He barely managed to work it out. And that's really, I think that really shows how good their timing is. Like, he knows exactly when he's able to start getting over there to save his teammate and still get the edge guard, which is really important. Because a lot of people will, like, go over there and try to, like, half edge guard, and then they'll be like, oh shit, my teammate needs help. And then they'll just kind of abandon it, and nothing will happen. They'll just kind of reset back to neutral without gaining any stocks. So people either need to commit or like just learn exactly when they're able to do it. And I mean, Fox is really fast, so he's able to do both, but in general. Committal is really important about this. Oof. Converting that up smash off the dash attack. That was pristine. And the coverage. Danny walking all the way back as soon as he saw that angle and covering high as well. John Money's still going to be able to make it back, but he took a ton of percent, and they were able to also start a combo on this side down while he was getting edge-guarded. Unfortunately, that up smash not going where he wanted it to. And, that wasn't that good a DI, but he's still going to live. This is a lot more even, but that up smash is going to kill. Danny gets grabbed, and this could be huge. He kind of ran in there to save Nico, but Nico, as soon as he got grabbed, it should have just been over because he was already pretty much dead. Nico claiming his life with an up smash. Good combo and bad DI on that back air. So red team up about a half a stock right now. Pretty even. Oh, and they get the grab. No up smash though. And John going for the gimp, and he gets it. Yep. That's such a committal gimp though, because he loses his jump, and it's really easy for another Fox to just kind of go out there and shine him. But Nico was occupied with the other Fox. Oh, John gets the back air out of that too. John really brought this back pretty much by himself. He got that gimp and he got that back air off of it. What? I got play.
Fire! Fire!
So I down smashed a lot against Q, and now it's set two. And it looks like red team has finally gotten their stuff together because they now have a pretty insurmountable lead here. They're going to just lose it now that I said that, of course. No, but they got a solid three or four stock lead right now, and it just got expanded. This is looking pretty over. Ooh, didn't get the second hit of the up air like he wanted, but still a great combo starter. Oh, that up tilt. Oh, he's barely going to die. And he just... Well, okay, that was weird. Please don't throw this away. Don't throw this away. Right, up throw. Back air. Yep. Oh. Oh, perfect spot for the up smash. That was gnarly. And that's it. That shook whoever just got fucking hit really hard. Good lord. Good stuff to Gary Oak. Finally finding a static, or